Well, as you can see, Julie is a few years younger than I am. And she was a fourth-year medical student at Yale Med School. And she came by and she was taking a fifth year because a lot of the students take a fifth year to do research and to do studies, clinical studies. And she said she'd like to work with me. And I could tell she was a hard worker.
Yes, it's that Midwestern blood.
Yes, we're
that
both
I
from
have.
The Midwest.
Yeah.
And that helps us understand each other.
So I started on a project on Nevi.
Yep.
And I think within the next year to year and a half, we had, I don't know, seven or eight things published.
Projects.
And published and projects ongoing, so.
And then when Julie was a resident and we had the first edition, she read and proofed some of the chapters and found errors and made them better as a resident.
And I would get special little jobs like, here's a table, you know. See if you could add to this X and, you know, whatever in someone with HIV or findings in this genodermatosis.
So. Yes, she's very interested in genodermatosis. So she helped make them more simple for the reader because people tend to make them very complex and don't find the common threads.
I think that's one of the core things that we agreed upon, that I've learned from Dr. Bologna, and that's really key to the book is making things that seem like they're complex more understandable and to make information more user-friendly and to help take things so people can employ them in their practices. Well, I actually had a great opportunity that as a resident, I got to read the text before it was even available. So it definitely helped me, my education with that. So I had the, you know, help with some of the proofs and things like that because it just was published when I was a second year.
Mm-hmm.
So I had already, I think, read a good portion of it before it was even available to the public. And then my third year, it really kind of revolutionized, I'm saying this sounds like I'm tooting our own horn, but at that point it was great. All the residents were so excited to have this new resource out and with the really visual aspects of it with the tables and pictures and schematics, it was wonderful.
Well, I think we try very hard to give people enough basic science to understand new drugs that are being discovered and put into practice and, say, new ways to analyze tumors, that without that background information, you would just simply be memorizing new aspects of medicine. On the other hand, we don't bog people down with a lot of exceptions and a lot of detail regarding basic science. We use our schematics, like Scientific American did, such that you look at the schematic first, then you read the text. And sometimes you don't even have to read the text. You can get a nice visual appreciation of what might be a complex item, but we make it simple.
Yeah, and there's so much information out there. Like to give the example of genetic skin disease, there have been 1,000 genes that have been linked to a skin phenotype. And it's just not something that anyone can or that anyone really wants to memorize. And the goal is to synthesize that and to put things in groups and organize it in such a way that it becomes user-friendly to the reader.